Continuous movement so that there is no stagnancy. The media brings in a continuous, I will say, churning of thoughts. Whether it is in politics, whether it is in finance, whether it is in HR, whether it is in marketing, and that brings the new thought process. Media plays a lot important role in development of the economy of any nation. Apart from giving the thoughts, there are huge investments also going in this business. And those investments ultimately contribute to the growth of the industry. It brings a lot of plurality and basically a lot of transparency in the whole administrative, political and government scenario. It brings in behavioral changes. If you propel it rightly, we have seen recent elections, it has brought in a lot of behavioral changes. There are a lot of huge investments going into infrastructure development. See, if you look at last 10 years, I will say 2000 onwards, the amount of infrastructure which has gone into the development of infrastructure for telecom, and by virtue of which we today all are able to enjoy the smartphones we use, we are able to enjoy the internet. That's a lot of investment which has gone, and that has generated a lot of employment, a lot of opportunity for people to go and trade. All the websites of Snapdeals, Flipkart, Amazon, eBay, they are growing today because we have access to them. And access has been able to come through the infrastructure which we developed. And the infrastructure is being used because video drive that. It is a known fact in various markets, I'm sure a lot of very few people of you will be understanding that video drives the use of internet in any market. If you look at all media companies, all telecom companies, they try to push video services as much as possible. Two reasons. First of all, it consumes higher bandwidth, so gets them more revenue, so more billing for you people. And then it also drives the internet penetration actually. So it has a lot of impact on the behavioral changes and the infrastructure we are invested into it. And by that, a lot of employment is generated. If you imagine today, how much of employment is generated by these 800 channels, 6 DTH companies, and around 20 big cable operators in this country. If we sum total them, this industry employs more than 100,000 people, which is much, much more than the automotive industry today. And it has a huge potential to employ more and more people. It also gives a potential to the creativity of it. The people who are on the softer side of the programming, they get a lot of creativity. Another very important aspect of media industry is, which I'm sure you people will be understanding, is soft power. Soft power is that, see, when we deal with our neighbors or hostile nations, or there are two ways you deal with them. You deal with the basis of your military strength, and the other way is you deal with the soft power, that you impregnate those economies or those geographies with your thoughts, your views, your ideologies, and ensure that they hear only positive about you. And once they keep on hearing positive about you, the total environment changes. If you look at the countries which have grown culturally, they have been very strong nations if you go into the history. Because they have been able to give their ideas to their neighboring countries, neighboring geographies, or to the geographies which are hostile to them. Today, what we do in media, or what media has an important role in, that we are having lot of Sark nations around us. Few are hostile to us, few are friendly to us. And we all can use our media as a soft power to reach them with our views and our thought processes, which only not brings in harmony in our nation, but also ensures that there is a harmony in the nearby nations also. So this is something which is very important for us to all to realize. Today, if you look at Bollywood movies, they are being hit in Pakistan, Bangladesh, Nepal, Afghanistan, and there is a huge demand of it. And that's a part of media. Ultimately, they reach via satellite TV or maybe through some exchange of movies. Though Pakistan doesn't allow Hindi movies to be screened, but still a lot of people enjoy that. How much Pakistani programs we see? Very less. But there is a reverse traffic. So there is a huge build-up of relations out in that market. So, if we are looking at it, the role of media is huge in economic growth, because that's something which is very hidden of aspect of our businesses, that how do we put economy on the forefront. Now, we have understood what media industry is, what the role of economy is. Now let's move to another area of media, which is that what sort of media categories we divide in. There will be three broader categories we just classify into. One is that we have a first tier, which is normally the public service broadcasters, the Doordarshans of the world, BBCs of the world, CNNs of the world, which CNN is not now a public broadcaster, but BBC is a partial public broadcaster. Their role is basically to ensure that the welfare schemes being done by the government reaches the common man. The government viewpoint is heard by everyone. The languages which are not having enough of private participation are encouraged. The regional artisans and regional artists are basically encouraged in that. So public service broadcaster is the first level of the media we call. That is how we also started, by the way, of Doordarshan long back. And then this is mostly state funded, having public interest on the top of the mind, and is mostly national in the approach. Then we come to the second tier of the media, which is the private channels we call it. Basically private enterprises who are for-profit organizations, but have a motto to reach to the citizens of not only of the country, for the international market. Now, since I come from this sort of organization, Zee basically, today Zee reaches practically 129 countries in the world. We reach where all Indians stay, or people of Indian, people who are having interest in India stay. It generates quite a bit of substantial income for the group, and also ensures that our views and our culture reaches those countries. You will be surprised. We run an Indian channel dubbed in Russia, Russian language. Yeah. We run a channel, same soap opera which you see on DZTV, we dub it in Russian, we dub it in Bhasha, which is a Indonesian language. We dub it in Arabic, and we have an Arabic channel also. So we reach where all either Indians live or people interested in India live. So it's a global economy, slowly becoming a global economy. We had started with a focus in international market in 1998 with the interest that we will serve Indians who are staying abroad. And now slowly it has become a business where we are doing channels for not only Indians staying abroad, but for people who are interested in India. Like we have got two Arabic channels, one Russian, one Bhasha. We are doing subtitling in French of Hindi movies, which will be very interesting to watch and see if people know French actually. So it's a growing media we are looking at. Third tier of the media, which is now gaining strength, is the community media basically. So community radio, community television, which is not yet seen in India, but is definitely there in various countries, especially US, Canada, that the local communities run the TV for the purpose of dissemination of information, dissemination of the local programs. We did a similar experiment in Andhra quite years back. And believe me, it was very successful. See, if you pick up a small locality and show schools what are they doing during the daytime, in the evening what the ladies of the community are doing, and what is the, in the evening, what are the religious programs going on, everyone likes to be on the TV. They want to wash their face on the TV. So it's a very, very liked and a very, very, I would say, appreciated concept. It is a great hit. We did it around a few years back. But then the satellite channels could go up and ultimately we disbanded it. But it's a great project. Community radio is another thing which is coming up in Delhi.